B'siyata d'shmaya, we're going to learn Brachos Dav Zayin, starting from the top of the Omud. On Dav Zayin Omud Aleph, we're going to learn five memoros from Rabbi Yochanan in the name of Rabbi Yossi, and on Dav Zayin Omud Beis, we're going to learn eight memoros from Rabbi Yochanan in the name of Rabbi Shimon ben Yochai. Says the Gemara, Oma Rabbi Yochanan Mishum Rabbi Yossi. Minayin Shakadosh Baruch Hu Mispalil, where do we know that Hashem davens? Shenemar Vavyoisim El Harkochi V'Simachtim Beveis Tfilosi. Hashem says that the Beis Hamikdash is a Beis Tfilosi. Tfilosom Lo Nemar. It doesn't say it's a place where you, Klal Yisrael, will daven. It's a place, Tfilosi, where Kiviyochel I will daven, so to speak. Elo Tfilosi. Mikan Shakadosh Baruch Hu Mispalil. There's a concept, so to speak, that Hashem davens. My matzli. What does he daven? Omer of Zutra bar Tuvia Omer Rav. He says as follows: Yehirotzo in Milfona. He davens, so to speak, to himself. And the Sforim explain that obviously Hashem is not speaking to himself. It's Hashem is causing one midah to enact, to switch on an even deeper midah. There's the Midas Hadin, which the world is created by, and when Hashem davens, Hashem is turning to the part of him that uses the Midas HaRachamim in order that the Midas HaRachamim should overpower the Midas Hadin. Yirotzun Milefonai, it should be my desire, Sheyichpashu Rachmai Eskasai, that my mercy should conquer my anger, V'yigoylu Rachamai Al Midoisai, and my mercy should override and overcome my midas hadin. V'esnaig imbonai b'midas harachmim. I should treat my children, Klal Yisrael, with mercy. V'ikonis lem lifnim mishuras hadin. And I should deal with them with a hanhoga, with a type of midah which is even more pnimius, more closer to the heart than the midas hadin. And that's the midas harachmim, the loving kindness and mercy of Hashem. Tanya, Omer Rabbi Shmuel ben Elisha. Rabbi Shmuel ben Elisha was a Kohen Gadol. Pamachas nichnasti, once on Yom Kippur, I went into the Kodesh HaKadoshim lehaktir k'tayres, to bring the k'tayres. Lifnai v'lifnim, in the Kodesh HaKadoshim. V'ro'isi akasrike el ko Hashem tzvokis, shu yoshev al kisei rom v'niso. He saw akasrike el ko Hashem tzvokis. We have no idea what these things mean, but whatever this was, so to speak, sitting on a very high throne. V'omer li, and said to me, Yishmoel, Bni, my son, Borcheini, give me a brocha. Omar tiloi, I, Yishmoel HaKohen Gadol, said to Hashem, Yirotzoin milfonecho. It should be your will, Sheyich b'shura chamesh choes kascho, that your mercy should conquer your anger, V'yigoylu rachamecho al midaysecho, and your midas harachamim should overcome the midas hadin, v'tisnaigim banecho b'midas harachamim, v'tikones lohem lifnim mishuras hadin. V'nanea li b'roishoi. And Hashem kiviyochel nodded his head as if in agreement. V'kumash malon, and this is teaching us, sh'lo yitei birchas hedyoit kala b'inecho. Even if a simple, ordinary person gives you a brocha, it should not be cheap in your eyes. If Hashem appreciates a brocha from a human being, so to speak, so too we should appreciate the brocha from any yid or any simple person. Next member, V'omer Rabbi Yochanan Mishum Rabbi Yossi, Minayin She'ein Meratzin Lo Le'odom B'Sha'as Kasoy. Where do we learn from that one should not try and appease somebody while he is still angry? Tichsiv, it says in the Pasuk, Pona Yeleichu V'Anichoy Siloch. What does that mean? Omer le HaKadosh Baruch Hu le Moshe, Hashem said to Moshe Rabbeinu, Hamtein li, wait ad sheyavru ponim shel zam, until the hanhoga of chaos passes, v'aniach lecho, and then I will let you rest. U'mi'ikar rischa kamid kutshabrichu, Hashem gets annoyed. So obviously Hashem himself doesn't get annoyed, as we know from the animamins, Hashem himself is beyond all these emotions and any physical traits. We're talking about the way Hashem reveals himself to us. So is there a concept called kas? The answer is the Gemara. In there is the Tanya, as we saw in the Braisa, V'keil zoyim b'chol yoyim. Hashem gets angry, k'v'yachol, every day. V'kamo za'amoy. How long is Hashem angry for? Rega, just for a moment. V'kamo rega. How much is a moment? And we're going to see there's at least two opinions in the Gemara. The first one is Echod mechameshes rivo yushmoines alofim ushmoine meis ushmoine ushmoina basha. One of 58,888 of an hour, which is a 16th of a second. Vazui rega, that's a moment. Vain kol beria yechayla lechavin oisa sha. It's impossible to be able to catch the moment. Chutz mi bila marasha, the only one who could do this was the bila marasha. Tichsiv Beit says in the Pasuk regarding Bilam, V'yodea das elyoin, he knew the mind of Hashem. Asks the Gemara, Hashta das behemtoi lo havayoda, he didn't even know what was going on in the mind of his animal. Das elyoin havayoda, he would know what's going on in the mind of Hashem? Of course not. Elo melamid shehoya yodea lechavin oisa shah shakadosh baruch hu koyiz bo. He knew that was his power with the tumah that he had and the koichas that he had. He managed to figure out exactly when this moment was. That means he didn't know what was going on in Hashem's mind, kivyachol. He just knew what was going on in Shemayim when Hashem was angry. V'hainu d'omer luhu novi liyishol. The Novi Micha said to Klal Yisrael, Ami, my folk, my people Klal Yisrael, Zechor no mayoatz Bolok melech Moav, remember what Bolok plotted against you, Vegoimer, etc. And he carries on, Lemandas Tzidkeis Hashem, in order that you should become aware and conscious of Hashem's kindness. My Leman Tzidkeis Hashem, what was this special kindness that Hashem did during the time that Bolok was trying to plot against us? Omer Belozor, Omer Lohem, HaKadosh Baruch Hu Yisrael, Hashem said to Klal Yisrael, Du'u kamo Tzidkeis Utzdokeis Osisi Imochem. You should know how kind I was to you, Klal Yisrael, Shalei Ko'asti Bimei Bila Marosha. I did not get annoyed even once all the time that Bilam was trying to plot against you. Shel Molei Ko'asti, had I been annoyed, Lo Nishtayir Misreneim Shel Yisrael Sorid Opolit. There would be nobody left of the enemies of Klal Yisrael. That's just the way the Gemara doesn't want to speak negatively about Klal Yisrael, so it refers to the enemies of Klal Yisrael. But the intentions of the Gemara is that if Hashem would have got annoyed, Bilam Chas V'Shalom would have succeeded in destroying Klal Yisrael. V'hainu d'k'oma lei Bilam l'Bolok, and Bilam actually owned this up to Bolok and said to him, Mo ekoiv lo ikovoi keil, how can I curse when Hashem isn't in that state? How can I cause anger when Hashem's just not angry? All those days, Hashem did not get annoyed. How long is the zam, the anger of Hashem? Rega, a moment. How much is a moment? This is a second opinion as to the length of a moment, the length of time Hashem is annoyed every day. Rega, commemorate, as long as it takes to say a single word. According to the Chofetz Chaim, that says one can say approximately 200 words in a minute, a word takes about a third of a second. And the truth is that Rabbeinu Tam in Sefer Yashar brings from a Tosefta in Maseches Brachos that the length of a rega is approximately a quarter of a second. And that's about as much time as one needs to say a single word. Tosus actually says that one can say in one word, in 1 second, one can say kalim, destroy. It's a three-letter word. Uminol on the rega rosach. How do we know bichlal that Hashem is annoyed for a moment? Shenemar, it says in the pasuk, ki rega ba'apoy. When Hashem is angry, has af, it's only for a rega. Chaim b'rtoynei, but Hashem's desire to give life lasts a lifetime. V'ibayis eima mehocha. Or another source that Hashem gets annoyed for a moment. It says in the pasuk, Chavi, hide, kim'at rega, just for a moment, ad yaver azam, until the anger passes. So you see that Hashem gets angry just for a moment, just for a rega. Ve'imus rosach, during which time of the day does Hashem get annoyed? We know how long he gets annoyed for, but when is that? Omer Abaye, Bahanoch, Tlas Shoi, Kamaisa, in the first 3 hours of the day. ki chivra karbalta de tarnagoyla. When the comb of a rooster becomes pale, becomes white, v'koi achat kara, and the rooster stands on one foot, that is when Hashem gets annoyed. Asks the Gemara, kol shaita v'shaita nami koi hochi. A rooster stands like that often. Kol, says the Gemara, kol shaita ispei shuraiki sumki. When he stands like this all the other hours, even though its comb is paled, and even though it stands on one foot, but there's streaks of red in its comb. But he shaita, that rega, when Hashem gets annoyed, lespei shuraiki sumka, there are no streaks of red in its comb. Says the Gemara, hahu tziduki, dehava b'shvuvisei Rabbi Yeshua ben Levi. There was this kofer tziduki that lived in the close proximity of Rabbi Yeshua ben Levi. Have a kometzair leituva, used to harass him a lot, bekroi, quoting or misquoting psukim against our belief system. Yom echad, one day, shokal tarnagoyla, Rabbi Yeshua ben Levi took a rooster, v'oikma ben kari, the arasa, he put it between the feet of his bed, v'ayin bo, and he was gazing at it to try and find out and determine exactly which second Hashem is annoyed. He was hoping that at that second he would be able to curse this neighbor and put an end to his trouble. Sovar kimota hu shaita alatya. When that moment arrives, I'll curse this tzeduki. Kimota hu shaita, when just before that moment arrived, Naim Rabbi Yeshua ben Levi fell asleep. Omar, when he woke up and realized that he'd fallen asleep, just in that moment, he said, Shma mino, it's clear, lav oirech aro lemeh v'tochi, it's improper to do this. Hashem was teaching me that it's not the way for a tzaddik to punish Roshoim. V'racham of alkol ma'asov k'siv, the posuk says one should have mercy on all of Hashem's creations. Ochsiv, and there's another posuk that says, Gam anoish le tzaddik, loitoiv, it's not good for a tzaddik to punish others. Tonim ishmeid Reb Meir, it said in the name of Reb Meir, b'shor she'achamu zirachas, in the morning when the sun comes out, v'chol malchim mizrach ha'mayrev, and all the kings of the nations, manichin kisreim b'roshem, are putting their crowns on their heads, u'mishtachvim l'chamo, and they are bowing to the sun, as if the sun is some upper power, some higher power. Avodah Zarah, miyad koyis HaKadosh Baruch Hu, that's when Hashem gets annoyed. Continues the Gemara, a third memra, Va'omar Rabbi Yochanan Mishum Rabbi Yosi. Toivo mardus achas beliboi shel odom yoise mekama malkiyos. We know that when a person gets lashes, it puts him back on the straight and narrow. But even better than that is if a person can do that himself. Self-discipline, mardus achas beliboi shel odom, that he did it on his own, it wasn't done to him from the outside by being hit, is even better than that. Shenemar, as it says in the Pasuk, V'ritfo es ma'aveo v'goymer v'omro ilcho v'oshuvo el ishi orishoin ki toiv li oz me'oto. Resh Lakish says, Yoisa mimeo malkiyos, it's even better than 100 lashes. Shenemar tachas ge'oro v'meivin me'akois ksil me'o. It's better for a person to be maven, to understand and to get close to Hashem because of his own awareness, rather than needing to be hit 100 times. The next memra from Rabbi Yochanan. V'om Rabbi Yochanan mishum Rabbi Yosi. Shloisha dvorim bikeish Moshe milifnei HaKadosh Baruch Hu v'nosan loy. Moshe Rabbeinu asked Hashem, he requested three things, v'nosan loy, Hashem granted them to him. Bikesh etishre shchino al Yisrael, he wanted that the shchina should be present with klal Yisrael, but nosan lo, he got it. Shenemar, as it says in the pasuk, halui belechtecho imonu, Hashem, we want you, the shchina, to be present with us. Bikesh lo etishre shchino al oivdei kechovim, v'nosan lo. Moshe asked that the shchina should not rest amongst the umay sa'ilom, and Hashem gave it to him. Shenemar, as it says, v'niflinu ani v'amoch, you and klal Yisrael, I Hashem, and you, Moshe, and Klal Yisrael are going to be unique and different from all the other Umay Sa'ilam, that with the Umay Sa'ilam, I'm not going to rest my Shechina amongst them, but with you, I will. Bikesh lo yidiyo yidrochav shel HaKadosh Baruch Hu. Moshe Rabbeinu wanted to understand Hashem's ways in the Hanhoga, the way he deals with people, the way he responds to our actions. V'nosan lo, and Hashem gave that understanding to Moshe. Shenemar, as it says, Hoyde'einino es derachecho. Moshe asked, let your ways be known to me. Omar lefonov ribbono shleilim, what did Moshe Rabbeinu want to know? He wanted to know, mipnei ma yesh tzadik v'toiv loy. Sometimes we see a tzadik and everything is good for him. V'yesh tzadik v'ra loy, and sometimes a tzadik where things are bad for him. Yesh rosha v'toiv loy, you have a rosha that things are going good for him. V'yesh rosha v'ra loy, and there's a rosha that things are going bad for him. How does this make sense? I want to understand it. Omar loy, Hashem answered, Moshe, I'll explain it to you. Tzadik v'toiv loy, the tzadik that's good for him, Tzadik ben tzadik. If he's a tzadik, his father was a tzadik, it will be good for him. Tzadik v'raloi. If he's a tzadik, but his father was a rosha, then it's going to be bad for him. Tzadik ben rosha. Rosha v'toivloi. When will a rosha be good? When will it be good for a rosha? Rosha ben tzadik. He's a rosha. His father was a tzadik, it will be good for him. Rosha v'raloi is rosha ben rosha. If he's a rosha and his father was a rosha, then for this rosha things will go bad. Omar Mar, Tzadik v'toiv loy, Tzadik ben Tzadik, Tzadik v'ra loy, Tzadik ben Rosha? Are you telling me that it's possible to be a Tzadik, and because the father was a Rosha, it's going to be ra loy, it's going to be bad for this Tzadik? Eini, how is that possible? The Voksiv, does it not say in the Pasuk? There's two Pesukim. In one Pasuk it says, Poikei davoin ovois albonim, indeed the children can suffer from the averus of the father. Uchsiv, there's another pasuk that says, "Ubonim lo yumsu al ovis," that children will not suffer and die because of their parents' averus. Uraminon kroy adodi, and these psukim are contradicting each other. Umashaninon, we asked the contradiction, and we answered as follows: Lo kasha, it's not a question. Hakasha oirzin maisi avosem biyodem. Hakasha in oirzin maisi avosem biyodem. If the son is also a rosha like his father, he can get punished for his father's averus. But if the son is a tzaddik, even though the father was a rosha, the son will not get punished. So how can you say here that tzaddik ben rosha is going to be a tzaddik v'raloi? If he's a tzaddik, he's not following his father's ways, then he will not get punished for his father's averus. This is what Hashem explained to Moshe Rabbeinu. Tzadik v'toiv loy, tzadik gomor. A person who's an absolute tzadik, it will be good for him. Tzadik v'ra loy is a tzadik she'enei gomor. If he's a tzadik, but he's not a tzadik gomor, he's not a complete tzadik, then it won't always be so good for him. Rosha v'toiv loy, rosha she'enei gomor. A rosha that's not an absolute complete rosha, it will be toiv loy. Rosha v'ra loy is a rosha gomor. A rosha who's a complete and absolute rosha, things will go bad for him. This that Rabbi Yechanan said in the name of Rabbi Yossi, that Moshe asked for three things and all three were granted, seems to be arguing with Rabbi Meir. The last question, when Moshe said, explain to me your ways, where Rabbi Yossi said that Hashem explained it to him. Yeah, it depends on what level of a tzaddik or rasha he is. But Rav Meir held that Hashem did not answer him. Shenemar, as it says in the pasuk, "V'chanoisi es hashochin afal pisha einoi hogun." You're right. You're sometimes going to see that it's going to be toiv lei for somebody, and he's not deserving of it. And nonetheless, I'm giving it to him, and you can't understand it. V'rechamti es hasharachim, I'll have mercy on people. Afal pisha einoi hogun. You're going to see me having mercy on people that it looks like they were roshoim, and you're not going to understand it. They're not deserving of the mercy, and nonetheless, I'm dealing with them and acting with them with mercy. Now the Gemara continues with the dialogue that was going on between Hashem and Moshe. Hashem said to Moshe Rabbeinu, you cannot see my face, so to speak. Hashem said to Moshe as follows, Kesherotzisi, you at the snare, Loi rotzisa, you didn't want. Achshav shato roitze, now that you want to see me, eini roitze, I don't want you to be able to see my face. Upligi dir b'shmul b'nachmeni or m'b'yechanon. Da'om b'shmul b'nachmeni or m'b'yechanon. B'schar shloisha shalish zochal shalish. As even the Rabbi Shua ben Korcho said that the fact that Moshe did not want to see Hashem, did not want to get close to Hashem at the snare, was a reason that Hashem didn't allow Moshe to see his face. But according to Rabbi Yonason here, we're going to see that it was actually a maila that Moshe did not want to be seen, did not want to see Hashem at the snet. Bischar, the pasuk says, "V'yastir Moshe ponov ki yorei mehabit Eloha Elokim." And the Gemara is going to say that there's three terms here. There's Vayaster Moshe Ponov, Moshe hid his face. Ki yore, he had fear of Hashem. Mehibit el ho'elukim, from seeing Hashem. Or he didn't want, he had fear, or he feared seeing Hashem. And these three things, says the Gemara, Bishar Vayaster Moshe Ponov, in the merit that Moshe hid from seeing Hashem, Zocho leklast upon him, he merited that later his face shone after Matan Torah. Bischar ki yorei, the reward for the fact that he had fear of Hashem, Zocho levayiru migeshes elov, that the shine on his face caused a fear in the people, that people were so fearful of Moshe they couldn't go anywhere near him. Bischar mehibit, in the schar that he didn't gaze at Hashem, Zocho utmunas Hashem yabit, he merited at Matan Torah that he saw some type of tmuna, some type of picture. We don't understand what these things mean. Continues the Gemara. The pasuk says, "Vasiroisi es kapi voraisa es achayrei." Hashem said, "You can see from behind. You can't see my face from the front." Omer of Chana bar Bizna, Omer of Shimon Chasida, Melamed Shehera Kadosh Baruch Hu LeMoshe Kesher Shel Tefillin. Hashem told Moshe, "You can't see my face. You can see the straps of my tefillin." We learned in a previous Gemara on Davov, Hashem has tefillin. Hashem said, "I'll show you the Kesher Shel Tefillin at the back of my head." And obviously, these are referring to very deep and esoteric concepts, and we can read the Gemara, but we cannot really understand them in their physical terms. Continues the Gemara, the fifth memra from Rabbi Yochanan. Va'omer Rabbi Yochanan l'shum Rabbi Yosi, kol dibur v'dibur shayotzo mipi HaKadosh Baruch Hu l'toivo, anything Hashem says to the positive, afilo al tenai, even if Hashem makes a condition and the condition is not met, nonetheless le'chozar bo, he does not retract from it, he keeps his word. Minol on where do we know this from? Mimoshe Rabbeinu, from Moshe Rabbeinu after the Egel, Shenemar Heref Mimeni Vashmidim Vegoimer Vese Oischa Lagoi Otsum. Hashem told Moshe, "I'll destroy Klal Yisrael and I'll make you into the leader, into the father of a whole nation." Afal gav the boy Moshe Rach Mialod Milsa Ubotla, even though Moshe Davin Hashem should have mercy on Klal Yisrael and not destroy them, and the Gzeira was in this battle, Hashem did not destroy Klal Yisrael. Afilahocha Oikm Bazari, nonetheless, Moshe's children became plenty and many as the whole of Klal Yisrael. Shneimer, as it says in the pasuk, Bnei Gershoim, Bnei Moshe Gershoim Eliezer. Vayu Bnei Eliezer Rechavya Horoish Vegoimer, Bnei Rechavya Rabu Lemaila Vegoimer. The descendants of Moshe Rabbeinu were Rabu Lemaila. They were very, very many. The Tanya of Yosef. Rav Yosef explained, Lemaila Meshishim Riboy, more than 600,000 were descendants of Moshe Rabbeinu. He learned that Asya Rabya Rabya Tzegzeis Shava Ksiv Hacha Rabu Lemaila. And regarding the descendants of Moshe Rabbeinu, it says in the pasuk, "Ubnei Rechavya Rabu Lemaila." Uchsiv Ha'osam. And regarding Klal Yisrael who came out of Mitzrayim, it says, "Ubnei Yisrael Poru Vayishrutzu Vayirbu." It also uses a term called Vayirbu. They were many. And the same as the many, the plentifulness of Klal Yisrael was 600,000, so too the descendants of Moshe Rabbeinu, they were more than 600,000. Now we're going to start learning the memories of Rabbi Yochanan in the name of Rabbi Shimon ben Yochai. Omar Rabbi Yochanan mishum Rabbi Shimon ben Yochai. Miyoyim shebora kodesh baruch hu es ha'olam lehoya odom shekori lekodesh baruch hu odoin ad shebo Avram avinu vekori odoin. From the time that Hashem created the world, nobody called Hashem Odoin, a master, until Avram Avinu came and called him Odoin Shenemar Vayomer Adnus Elohim Bamoeda Ki Ereshenu. Hashem referred to Avram Avinu referred to Hashem with the term Adnus as a master and Odoin. Omar Rav. Rav said, after Neil Leinene Elo Bishvil Avram, the Neil who needed his tefillahs to be answered was only answered in the schus of Avraham Avinu, who called Hashem a master. Shenemar, it says in the pasuk that Daniel said, "Va'ato shmaili kenu el tefillas avdecho ve'el tachanunov v'hoir ponecho al mikdoshcho hashomim leman adnus." That Daniel turned to Hashem, asking him for mercy, for the sake or in the name of in the merit of Adnos. Says the Gemara, he was talking to Hashem. Why didn't he say, Lemancha miboyele? In for your sake, Hashem. For you, I want you to have mercy on Klal Yisrael and the Beis HaMikdash. Elo leman Avram shekarucha odin. Daniel didn't mean, when he said leman adnus, he didn't mean Hashem, you, for your sake. He meant in the schus of Avram who called you an odin. So you see that Daniel had to come to the schus of Avram Avinu in order for his tefillahs to be answered. Ba'omer Rabbi Yechlon Meshum Rabbi Shimon Bar Yochai Minayin She'ein Meratzin Loi La'odom B'Sha'as Kasoy She'ne'em Marpona Yileichu V'Anichoysi Loch. Rabbi Yechlon on Amud Aleph said exactly the same memra in the name of Rabbi Yossi, and here he said in the name of Rabbi Shimon Bar Yochai. It seems he heard this same thing from both his Rebbes, that we don't try and appease somebody when they're still annoyed. As it says, Pona Yileichu V'Anichoysi Loch, Hashem told Moshe Rabbeinu, wait till my anger passes and then things will rest. There is a difference between the two, and I do not know if there's any relevance to this, that on Amud Aleph it says Tichsiv, and here it says Shenemar. I don't know if that makes a difference. Says the Gemara, the third memra of Rabbi Yechlon, Va'omer Rabbi Yechlon Mishum Rabbi Shimon Ben Yichai, Miyoyim Shebora Kudish Baruch Hu Yesei Lomoy, from the time Hashem created the world, Loihoya Odom Shehoide LaKudish Baruch Hu, there was no one who thanked Hashem, who praised Hashem, Ad Shebos Leo, until Leo came Vahidosoi, and she thanked Hashem, Shenemar Hapam, now that Yehuda was born, her fourth child was born, and she knew with Ruach HaKodesh that each of the four Imois were supposed to give birth to a quarter of the 12 Shvatim, which is 3 Shvatim each. And here Leo had given birth to the fourth one. This was more than she really deserved, and she thanked Hashem. That's why she called her fourth child Yehuda. Shenemar Hapam Oides Hashem, I'm thankful and grateful to Hashem. And it seems that once the Gemara explains Yehuda, the Pasuk actually says Yehuda, who's called Yehuda because Hapam Oides, a lotion of thanking, the Gemara is now going to explain some other names. Reuven, what was hidden in the name Reuven? Something that showed Al Shema Osid, what was going to happen to or with Reuven. Omre Belozar, Omro Leo, when Leo called her first son Reuven, then with Ruach HaKodesh, she felt the following. Reu ma bein beni, see the difference between my son Reuven, leben Echomi, and the son of my father-in-law, meaning Esav. De'ilu ben Chomi, Esav, afal gav demidaita zovne lebechiru, say, he willingly, out of his own choice, sold the bechira to Yaakov Avinu. Tichsiv vayimkeres bechirosei liyaakov. Chazu maksiv be, see what it says there afterwards. Vayistim Esav es Yaakov, uchsiv vayime hachikoro shmo Yaakov, vayakveni ze pamaim. He was always complaining that Yaakov cheated him and stole the brachas from him, and he was not happy with the sale. Ve'ilu bni, my son Reuven, Reu, loshon of seeing, see the difference between them. My son Reuven, afal gavda al korchei shokle, Yaakov lebechirosei ve'yoav el Yosef. Even though Yaakov by force took the bechira away from Reuven and gave it to Yosef, tichsiv, as it says in the pasuk, uvechalu lo yitzuei aviv nitna bechirosei levnei Yosef. He was not jealous of Yosef. It was Reuven that when he first heard that they wanted to kill Yosef, he was the one that came to save the situation and try and save Yosef, even though he knew that he'd lost his bechira to Yosef. Rus, we know that one of the ancestors of David HaMelech was Rus. Why was she called Rus? My Rus. David, she was the ancestor of David HaMelech, and David, Sherivehu LaKadosh Baruch Hu, he sated Hashem b'shirayis v'sishbochis. He quenched all the thirst kaviyachol Hashem had, that people should praise him. David HaMelech quenched that thirst and was Rivehu LaKadosh Baruch Hu b'shirayis v'sishbochis. And the Gemara says, Minolon Dushmo Gorim, how do you know that there's a meaning in the name, that the name actually contributes to what happened to the child? Om Rabbi Eliezer, Da'omakro, it says in the Pasuk, L'chu chazu mif'alis Hashem, see the wondrous works of Hashem, Ashesom shamois ba'od ba'oretz, who he places shamois ba'oretz, shamois in the land. Al tikro shamois, which means devastation, Eloshemois, which means names. Part of the wonders of Hashem in the world is the concept of a name, that the name is not only some agreement or way that we're going to refer to something or somebody, it's actually the essence and definition of the whatever's holding the name. The next member of Omer Rabbi Yochanan Mishum Rabbi Shimon ben Yochai, Kosher Tarbo Yisroa Basoich Beisoi Shel Adam, having a wayward child in the home is harder for a person, Yoitzer Mimelchemis Goig Umogig, more than the wars of Goig Umogig. Shenemar, as it says, Mizmer LeDavid Bevorchem B'pnei Avshonim B'noi, in the Perek in Tehillim, where David HaMelech is crying about his situation with Avshalom, his son, Uchsiv Basrei, it says in the next Pasuk, Hashem or Rabu Tzorai, my tormentors are so many, Rabim Komim Olai, so many are coming to stand against me. Ve'ilu Gabi Melchemes Goig Umogig, when David HaMelech speaks about the war of Goig Umogig, Ksiv Loma Rokshu, Goim Ul'umim Yegurik. He's saying that why are people for no good reason, they're fighting Klal Yisrael, Ve'ilu Morabu Tzorai, Loiksiv, referring to Goig Umogig, doesn't say how many the tormentors are. So it seems that there's an element much worse and harder with a wayward child, even more than the wars of Goig Umogig. Now the Gemara says, that very Perek, speaking about Avshalom, that was a wayward child who actually tried to kill David HaMelech, his father, Mizmor LeDavid, Bevorchem Epnei Avshalom Benoi, this was the song of David when he was running away from his son Avshalom. Mizmor LeDavid, you're calling this a song? Kino LeDavid Miboile, he should have called it a kino, he was lamenting a situation. He wasn't singing about the situation. Omer Reb Shimon ben Avishalom, he says, Reb Shimon ben Avishalom says, I'll explain it to you with a marshal. L'mo'adov adoyme l'odom shi'otzo lov shtar chiv. If somebody comes out, if somebody owes somebody else money, and that somebody comes to him with a shtar and says, look, you owe me money. Koidim sheporoi hoya otsev, before he paid up the debt, he was otsev, he was a bit upset. He was worried. La'acha sheporoi, once he paid up his whole debt, sameach, he was happy. Afkein, so too, David. Kivan sh'omer le'akadosh baruch hu, Hashem had told him beforehand, hineni mekim alecha ra'o mibeischa. There's going to be some evil that's going to come out of your house. Hayotziv, David HaMelech was worried. Omar, he said, Shemo Eved, maybe it will be a slave or a mamzer who is not going to have any pity on me. Kivan dechazod Avshalom, who once he realized it was his own son Avshalom that was going to be this evil person coming from his house, causing him torment. Somach, David HaMelech was happy. He knew that if it was his son would ultimately have pity on him, or so David HaMelech assumed. Mishumhochi Omer Mizmer, and that's why he called it a song. Continues the Gemara, the fifth memra. V'omer Rabbi Yochanan Mishum Rabbi Shimon ben Yochai. Mutter lizgaris b'roshoim b'oilom hazeh. It's mutter to challenge and compete with the roshoim in this world, to contend with them. Shenemar, as it says, oizvei toira yehalulu resha. The Roshoim, the people who leave the Torah, they praise the Roshoim. With Shoimrei Torah, but those who keep the Torah, Yizgarubam, they challenge and contend with the Roshoim. Tanin Amiochi, also in a Braisa, Reb Dostoi Bar Reb Motun Oimer, Mutter Yizgaris Bar Roshoim, you're out to challenge the Roshoim. Bo'ilim Azein, in this world, Shneemar brings the same Pasuk, Oizvei Torah, Yehalulu Resha, with Shoimrei Torah, Yizgarubam. Ve'im Loch Shecha Odom, if somebody's going to whisper into your ear, Loima to say, Voksiv, I've got another Pasuk that says, Al Tischar B'mereim, don't challenge the Roshoim, Al Tikane Boise Avlo, don't be zealous, don't have kanos against the evil people. And Moyuloi, say to that person who's whispering this in your ears, Misha Liboy Noikfoy Oimer Kain, only somebody who's very self conscious is saying this. Because what does that pasuk mean? Elo al tischar b'mereim means don't compete with them. Liyis k'mereim, to try and be like the bad people. V'al tekane doesn't mean don't be kanos against them. It means al tekane, don't envy them. Bo'ise avlo, the people who are doing Averis, Lias Koisi Avlo, to try and compete with them and be like them. But of course, if you can challenge them to try and beat them, of course you're allowed to. Vo'imer, and it says, Al Yekane Lipcho Bachatoim, your heart should not envy the people doing Averis, Kiim Biyiras Hashem Kol Hayoim, you should be envious of the people of Yiras Shemaim. Ask the Gemara, so you're saying in the name of Rav Shimon ben Yochai that Mutal is Garius Burushoim Boilam Azeh, Eini, we've got proof otherwise. V'omer Bietzchok, did Bietzchok not say, if you see that Rosha, looks like time is on his side, he's having a good time, even though he's a big Rosha, Altis Garaboy, do not challenge him. Don't try and rate him on. Shenemar, as it says in the Pasuk, Yechilu Durachov B'chol Eis. This Rasha will be successful all the time. If you start with him, you're prone to lose the fight against him. Not only that, if there would be a judgment against this Rasha, temporarily he would win the case. Shenemar Mirum Mishpotecho, Mori Mishpotecho, Minegdoi, that even your mishpat of din against him, morim, it's beyond him, he'll get past it. V'loi oid elo sheroya betzorov, he's going to see his enemy's downfall. Shenemar kol tzoyer of yofiach bohem, he's going to like blow them away, so don't start up with them, you may well lose. So how could you say that mutal iskaris b'roshoim bo'ilom azeh? Loi kasha. The Gemara is now going to suggest 40 rutzim, and all the Mefarshim discuss exactly the little details, the nuances between the 40 rutzim. It's not so clear at all. We're going to explain it according to one of the Mehalchim. So the first answer of the Gemara is Ha b'mili didei. A person that is challenging the Rosha for his own interests, that's not allowed. Ha b'mili d'shemaya. But if you're coming to challenge the Rosha for the sake of Torah and mitzvahs and to uphold the Yiddishkeit, there it's muta. V'iboy same with the second teretz, ha v'ha b'mili d'shmaya. They're both talking about mili d'shmaya. You're challenging him for good reasons, for Torah mitzvahs. Nonetheless, v'loi kasha, it's not a stira, it's not always allowed. Ha b'rosha sh'asham s'achek esloi, in a case where you can see that everything is going well for this rosha, then nobody should challenge him at all. But a Rasha where you don't see particularly that he's being successful and having a good time, then everybody's allowed to challenge him. The third explanation. Even in the case where the Shah Masachek Esloi, it's not always Mutter or Asa. V'loi Kasha. Ha B'tzadik Gomor. If the person who's challenging the Rosha is an absolute tzaddik, then even if Shama Sachek Esloi, you can challenge the Rosha. If you're not tzaddik gomor, then because Shama Sachek Esloi, you should not challenge him. But if Eina Shama Sachek Esloi, anybody can challenge him. Where do we see the difference between Rosha Gomor, Rosha She'ene Gomor, regarding challenging a Rosha? Do'omar Rav Huna, Maidich Siv, Lomo, Sabit, Boikdim, why do you gaze at those that are betraying you? Tachrish, Bevala, Rosha, Tzadik, Mimenu. And you're silent when a Rosha is swallowing a Tzadik of him, from him. Says the Gemara. V'chirosha bolea tzadik? Does a rosha swallow a tzadik? V'oksiv, it says in another pasuk, Hashem lo yazvenu b'yodoy. Hashem does not abandon a tzadik in the hands of a rosha. V'oksiv, another pasuk, lo yu'uno la tzadik kol oven. No evil will befall a tzadik. Elo tzadik mimenu, if he's a tzadik, is only more of a tzadik than the rosha, he's only relatively a tzadik, then bolea. Then the Rosha can swallow him. Tzadik Gomor, if he's a Tzadik Gomor, Einei Belea, then the Rosha cannot swallow him. And therefore, if Hashem Masachek Esloi, only a Tzadik Gomor should challenge him, a Tzadik She'einei Gomor should stay away from him. Ibo Yis'ema, the fourth answer of the Gemara is, Shom Masachek Esloi Shani, that when Shom Masachek Esloi, nobody should challenge him. And if Eina Shom Masachek Esloi, then the Tzadik Gomor can challenge him, and the tzaddik she'enei gomor should not challenge him. continues the Gemara with the next memra of Rabbi Yochanan. V'omar Rabbi Yochanan mishum Rabbi Shimon ben Yochai. Kol akiveh mokim litfilosoi, anybody who has a fixed place for davening, oyevov noiflim tachtov, his enemies will fall from under him. Shenemar, as it says in the Pasuk, v'samti mokim la'ami Yisroel, I will give Klal Yisrael a fixed place, which is meramez to a mokim kavua, litfila, unetativ v'shochan tachtov, v'lo yirgaz oid, v'lo yosifu b'nei avlo la'anoisoi, kasher borishoino. Consequent to having a fixed place will be that v'lo yirgaz oid, they won't be disturbed anymore, v'lo yosifu b'nei avlo la'anoisoi, the evil people will not be tormenting them anymore, kasher borishoino, as it was at first. Rav Huna Romi, ksiv la'anoisoi, Rav Huna asks a stira. We just read the pasuk in Shmuel that says that the bnei avlo, the evil people, will not be able to be anoisoi. They will not torment us. Uchsiv, in a very similar pasuk in Divrei Hayomim, it says lechaloisoi. They will not be able to destroy us. Says the Gemara, bitchila, when the Beis Hamikdash was first built, la'anoisoi, the schus of kviyas mokim bitfila helped that nobody should be able to torment them. Ulebasayif, after Klal Yisrael doing mu'avirus, lechaloisoi, the being kviyas mokim protected them from being destroyed, but did not protect them from being tormented. Says the Gemara, the seventh memra of Rabbi Yochanan. Va'omar Rabbi Yochanan mishum Rabbi Shimon ben Yochai. G'doyla Shimusha Shel Torah Yoisa Milimuda. There's an advantage, even more is said about serving those who are learning Torah, even more than learning the Torah. Shenemar Poi Elisha Ben Shofot Asheyotzak Maim Al Yidei Elio. When the Pasuk is talking about Elisha, who was a Talmud of Elio Anovi, Lomad Loi Nemar, it doesn't say he learned Torah by Elio Anovi. It says Elo Yotzak, he was serving Eliyahu Hanavi, he poured water over on the hands of Eliyahu. Melamed, from here we see Kshegdoilo Shimusha Yoisa Milimudo. It's even bigger is to serve somebody who is learning Torah, rather even more than learning Torah from them. Hashem, in the next Shea, we'll start on Dav Zayin Amud Beis, three lines from the bottom of the Amud.